Welcome to Introduction to the Auditing of Infrastructure Projects. This infrastructure course forms part of a wider e-learning series on environmental auditing. It's a massive open online course based on InterSci materials on infrastructure auditing and courses held in the EuroSci and AfroSci working groups on environmental auditing. But let's start from the very beginning. Why do we need to audit infrastructure in the first place?
It's important to audit infrastructure because governments need it in order to provide vital public goods and services. Also, infrastructure development requires spending quite a lot of public money and has environmental consequences. In other words, governments usually have a big part to play in both developing and utilizing infrastructure. Nevertheless, governments also need to protect their citizens and the environment from any damage that cannot be reversed.
Different types of infrastructure have different effects on the environment, so it's necessary to consider not only the benefits that stand to be gained, but also potential negative environmental and social effects when planning infrastructure projects.
But how do you audit infrastructure?
There are different ways you can audit it. Since infrastructure developments always involve spending large amounts of money, one way is to audit the spending. Another important aspect, though, is the extent to which infrastructure development affects the surrounding environment. Plus, you can also look at sustainability when talking about big infrastructure projects or the durability of the infrastructure and how long it is supposed to last, who maintains it, and how much this costs to taxpayers.
Since our course forms part of an environmental auditing series, we'll be focusing on environmental aspects and providing an introduction to evaluating sustainability. We'll also be giving you examples of environmental auditing based on our own experience at the National Audit Office of Estonia.
What can governments do to regulate infrastructure development?
The key role of the government in coordinating infrastructure development is establishing a good legislative framework, which should create favorable conditions for developing infrastructure, for effectively utilizing it to provide public services and for decommissioning it afterwards.
On the other hand, governments need to ensure that infrastructure development isn't random, so to speak, and that unnecessary and environmentally harmful infrastructure doesn't get built. It's the government's responsibility to set the rules for all stages of infrastructure development, from planning to utilization and decommissioning.
And if the government itself is the one who's developing new infrastructure projects, then the government itself is the one who has to abide by the rules.
But when should you audit infrastructure?
Well, you can audit it at virtually any stage of the project. Further on the course, we'll also be introducing the model from the InterSci infrastructure auditing material, which gives an overview of all the different steps in a project. Those steps were developed to ensure that the end result of a project is well thought out and will bring maximum benefits with minimum negative effects. The model also incorporates the government's role in developing infrastructure projects, meaning it describes what the government can and should do at each stage of the project.
We will also be elaborating on the role of audit institutions and what stages are most important to auditors in our experience. That said, infrastructure project can be audited at virtually any stage. The National Audit Office of Estonia, for example, is planning to audit certain aspects of the international railway project even before construction starts. Supreme audit institutions can audit planning, construction, utilization and decommissioning.
One last question. Is sustainable the same as environmentally friendly?
In short, no, they are not exactly the same. The environmental aspect usually forms part of sustainability, but there are other aspects. Further on in the course, we'll try to explain how to audit the sustainability of infrastructure using our own audit examples. The golden rule is to balance environmental, social and economic aspects, but it's quite difficult to strike that balance because it's difficult to decide which of the three is most important in the context of the particular project being analyzed.